Joel told me in the comments of this video that the cover I designed to close off the motor that is not in use for the CamVac could be designed so much better. Okay, I see where you are going. Because the cover that I made was just a functional design. Very quickly designed and good on the scale of the perfectionist. The motor that is not in use leaks some air and the cover prevents this. And it will increase the airflow with 6 to 15% depending on your setup. My second design iteration was a little bit better. It could facilitate the unused motor cover, so it won't get lost over time. Only it had a major issue though. And it was not the cover that was the issue, but it was me. Each motor of the CamVac can be used for 2 hours straight before it needs to cool down for 50 minutes. I use 2 motors and switch the motor that needs cooling. So, switching buttons is something that I can do. But thinking of releasing the cover is not my best thing. And luckily, your clever ideas came into the picture here. Because when we can create something that can eliminate the human error, then we have a design that is beyond excellent. So let's turn the valve ID into a real design. And not a normal valve, like Dennis from Hooked on Wood already made an art piece of. But a valve with a ball, a styrofoam one. When the motor is not on, the ball is sucked against the cup, so it seals the opening. Obviously, I put something over the ball to constrain it. And I did some design iterations to eliminate the need of support. Because halfway print, I need to pause the print to put the ball inside of the cage. Yeah, the process was not that smooth and simple. Just before pressing the print button, I realized something. Checking dimensions. Apparently, when you buy 6 cm styrofoam balls at the local art supply store shop, there is some crimflation going on. Because apparently 6 cm isn't 60 mm. It's just as shy of 57. So 5% less for the same price. Close call, but I saved here time and filament. Or not, because during the first test I found another flaw that could prevent us from climbing the perfectionist skill. It did trap air during the startup and prevents the ball to reaching the top. The ball did close off the outlet though, without getting stuck, even when I blocked the air intake from the extractor. Running the motor for 2 hours straight did not melt the styrofoam. But he didn't enjoy too much aggression. I did not use the strongest material for this print, just PLA. Also, the infill can be increased and I have space to enlarge the upright support structure a bit. But I can spend a whole new video on rigidity, what I'm not going to do. Okay, back to the drawing board. So I fixed the air trap by adding a clever device to let the air escape. I think I need to patent that, by the way. Let's continue where we left off. The ball is perfectly placed on the top now and slowly moving around. It's a fascinating view, but we need a video to finish. So let's move on. With all the ball valves in place, our latest test confirmed our previous findings. And I find it exciting to see that I started with this simple cover. And together with your brilliant ideas, we ended up with a design that is easy to use and eliminates human thinking. So where we ended on the perfectionist skill, I leave back to you. And I would like to hear it in the comments down below. So for now, thank you for watching. All the files are available on my Patreon. And I see you in the next video. Houdoe!